Hello and welcome to the session. In this session, we will discuss about the integrals of some particular functions. Here we mention some important formulae of integrals and apply them for integrating many other related standard integrals. The first one goes like integral of dx upon x square minus a square is equal to 1 upon 2a log modulus x minus a over x plus a plus c. Next is integral of dx upon a square minus x square is equal to 1 upon 2a log modulus a plus x over a minus x plus c. Then the next is integral of dx upon x square plus a square is equal to 1 upon a tan inverse x upon a plus c. Then integral of dx upon square root of x square minus a square is equal to log modulus x plus square root of x square minus a square plus c. Then we have integral of dx upon square root of a square minus x square is equal to sine inverse x upon a plus c. Next one is integral of dx upon square root of x square plus a square is equal to log modulus x plus square root of x square plus a square plus c. We need to remember these integrals for integrating many other related standard integrals. Let's try and find out the value of the integral I equal to integral of dx upon x square minus 25. This can be written as integral of dx upon x square minus 5 square. Looking at the denominator, we can very well see that we have to use the first formula, which goes like integral of dx upon x square minus a square is equal to 1 upon 2a log of modulus x minus a over x plus a plus c. So in this case, we are going to take a as 5 and we will substitute this value of a in the above formula. So we get 1 upon 2a log modulus x minus a over x plus a plus c. That is, we get I is equal to 1 upon 10 log modulus x minus 5 over x plus 5 plus c. Here the c is the constant of integration. Next is, if we have the integrals of the type integral dx upon ax square plus bx plus c, integral of dx upon square root of ax square plus bx plus c, integral of px plus q dx upon ax square plus bx plus c, and integral px plus q dx upon square root of ax square plus bx plus c. Then we can reduce them to the form so that we can apply the above discussed formulae to find the value of the integrals. Let's try and find out the value of the integral I equal to integral of dx upon square root of x square plus 2x plus 2. Let us try and reduce this integral to a form so that we can apply any of the above standard 6 formulas that we had discussed. For this, what we do is we write x square plus 2x plus 2 as x square plus 2x plus 1 plus 1. This is further written as x plus 1 the whole square plus 1 square. That is, now I is equal to integral of dx upon square root of x plus 1 the whole square plus 1 square. Then we substitute x plus 1 as t. This gives dx is equal to dt. So now this I becomes equal to integral of dt upon square root of t square plus 1 square. If you look at the denominator, you can easily see that we can use the sixth standard formula, which is integral of dx upon square root of x square plus a square is equal to log of modulus x plus square root x square plus a square plus c. In the formula, we will substitute x as t and a as 1. So we get this is equal to log of modulus x, that is t, plus square root of x square plus a square, that is t square plus 1 square plus c. Now we substitute this value of t, which is x plus 1. This gives us I is equal to log modulus x plus 1 plus square root of x plus 1 the whole square plus 1 plus c. That is equal to log modulus x plus 1 plus square root of x square plus 2x plus 2 plus c. This is the value for the integral I. Here the c is the constant of integration. In this way, we can reduce the given integrals to the form so that we can apply the standard formulae that we had discussed. This completes the session. Hope you have understood the integration of some particular functions and how do we apply these standard formulas.